Brought to you by GatewayCitySavers.com.
101ESPN.com presents the Redbird Report.
The St. Louis Cardinals have had so many different things go wrong for them this season, from injuries and poor performances. A lot of things that John Mozeliak assumed would go right this year did not. Now, each one individually, the Cardinals have done their best to withstand the repercussions of what it would mean going on throughout the course of the season. If someone gets hurt, you do your best to fill in for them. If someone doesn't play well, you do your best to find someone else who will, and then back that person who is struggling off and get them to play much better later on in the season. I think, all things being told, of everything that went wrong, the Cardinals did a reasonably good job with most of them in not letting those individually, like Skip Schumacher, Brendan Ryan, Kyle Loesch, Brad Penny getting hurt, a lot of these things, they did a nice job of making sure it did not ruin their season. But if you're looking for one, the number one problem that the Cardinals just could not overcome this season, it's got to be David Freese. And it's not just because of him, it's also the timing of it. When David Freese got hurt, they were under the assumption that he was going to be fine at some point in the near future. It just took him a little bit longer to get back. That's what they thought at that time. So they went with Felipe Lopez there and did not go out and get a third baseman before the trade deadline because they thought that David Freese was going to be back playing every day at third and driving in runs in the middle of the order, hitting either fifth or sixth like he was for the first couple months of the season. Well, then, obviously, since Felipe Lopez struggled a lot there, they were waiting and waiting and waiting for Freese to come back. Trade deadline passed, and what happens? David Freese hurt his ankle again in a rehab start in AA Springfield, out for the season, and the Cardinals were really in a bind. They did not go out and make a move for a third baseman before that non-waiver trade deadline, July 31st, so they were not able to go out and get somebody that they really wanted afterwards. The guys they did have interest in, guys like Ty Wigginton, Jose Lopez, Brandon Inge, they did not clear waivers, and the Cardinals were not able to get their hands on them. So the best person available, the best, was hitting .221 for the Houston Astros, and that is Pedro Feliz. And then you throw in Pedro Feliz, who obviously was hitting in the low 200s, Brendan Ryan, Skip Schumacher, Yadier Molina, and then the pitcher in the National League lineup. One of those guys, every single night, was hitting sixth. That is not good. You do not want someone that cannot drive in runs consistently protecting Albert Pujols, Matt Holliday, and then Colby Rasmus, 3, 4, 5 in the lineup, backing them up, hitting sixth. Skip Schumacher did that a lot. He is not a number six hitter. Yadier Molina was doing that a lot. He is not a number six hitter either. That right there, it was the timing of it, losing David Freese. That is the number one problem that the St. Louis Cardinals have not been able to overcome in this 2010 season.